Morning, viewers. Headed out this morning. Today's Sunday, October 23rd. Headed back out to what we've been calling Silvertown. And if you haven't caught the last video, get in and subscribe. Make a comment. I'm doing a silver giveaway. Speaking of giveaways, mentioned it before, Anthony's doing a big silver giveaway because he hit 1,000 subscribers. So he's got some good sized silver and really nice prizes. Head over to his page, subscribe, watch the video, make a comment, get in on his silver also. Hopefully we're going to get some decent finds today. I was going to try to meet up with Hillside Angler, but I haven't heard back from him, so maybe we'll get him in the picture today also. We'll see you when I get there. Okay, as I mentioned, Anthony at iDig History is doing a really big silver giveaway because he's reached 1,000 subscribers. His channel is iDig History. He uses the Washington tax token as a small icon, and the back page is a bunch of silver coins and silver jewelry. Looks like a little locket and some earrings. Anyways, the video you want to watch to get in on this is this one that I just clicked on. What it is it has a video of shows what he's going to be giving away, the prizes you can win, and the instructions how to get into that. The other thing I want to bring up is a couple videos ago, I brought up a gentleman by the name of Brighton West. He has three different channels here. Authentic West is the one I believe he uses to help people develop their YouTube channel. He's currently doing mostly for life coaches, but I imagine if you drop in line, have a look at your channel, he may be able to give you some pointers. Just get a hold of him. I believe he'll be able to help you get going on your channel, make it a little bit better. He gave me some pointers and I've started incorporating those. So I wanted to shout out to him and Anthony, so I can get into the silver draw, the giveaway a little bit better, because he'll add a couple more entries if you do a shout out. And Brighton, simply because I really liked visiting with the guy, chatting with him, and he did give me some pointers, so I'm going to give back to him. Thank you, and I hope you enjoyed today's video. Hey, this one here is a low tone, probably some garbage, as I usually dig on low tones like this. No low tone, no gold. And as I've been doing lately, as I've been trying to dig, a lot more low tones. And I've been finding more gold. Pretty shallow. Hold still. No. Yeah. And it's a low tone pull tab. Alright, moving on. This signal here is screaming out really loud. It's pretty much like a pop can. It only has 3 inches or so to it. It's probably gonna come out garbage. But you never know. That's just all over the board. Yeah, I see a thing. Bar. That's all it was. That Lincoln Memorial was screaming like that. Strange. Alright. Next hole. Okay, this one here is just got the stupidest sound. I don't know why I'm digging it. I think the only reason I'm digging it is because it's got about 6-7 inches on it. So we'll find out together what it is, if it's something good, otherwise you'll never know, because I won't put the video on there. It's garbage, of major junkage. Come on, stay together, you can do it. Nope, but you can stay together, not completely at least. Well, I made a hole. It's not a pretty one, but it's a hole. sounds just as bad now as it did before. That's not making noise. That's a really felt something hard. That's my shovel making a noise. Nope. Whatever it is, it's in the pile. 1 second. Oh, there it is. It's a green, green wheat. Alrighty. That was down there a ways. That one's really green. I'll have to get that one cleaned up. I'll make note of it at the end. But I did find something in that hole. Nice and deep target, too. Moving to the next one. Well, you see, sometimes it pays just to walk around with your eyes open and pay attention to what you're walking over. I just found this, it says Oregon Brewers Festival. It's an event that goes on downtown Portland on the waterfront, sitting right on the top, well, close to the top. I just happened to see something. I was going to reach down and pick up the garbage, and I got a wooden nickel token. Now I'm sitting over a tone that's high, and it's got about 6 inches to it. The numbers are all off, but as I've learned with E-Track, numbers don't mean anything. So I'm about 3 feet from where I just dug that real green wheat penny, and it's probably a copper penny that's throwing me this tone, but in case it's something better, I always record. Oh, I got a root or something in here. This is not going to be a nice plug. Okay. It's not a coin at all. I am not exactly sure what this thing is. I tend to find a few of these. I believe they're copper. Well, there that special thing is, and we'll move to the next spot. This one here is real, real high tone and real shallow. I expect that to be a toy or a quarter. Or some piece of garbage. It's a fence post top. Alrighty, moving on. This one here has got about 3-4 inches. I'm fairly certain it's probably a coin. We'll get her dug. We'll get her out. We'll see what it is. It's kind of broken up. But it just has consistent enough tone to make me dig it. And just enough depth to make me curious. No clue. Could be off to the side of it. There it is. Just the Lincoln Memorial. Moving on. This one has a quarter type tone. It's right on top. Right on top, alright. Look at it. It's a shiner, but it is not silver. The thing hasn't been on the ground at all for very long. Alright, moving on. I'm sitting over a decent tone. I had to work hard to get the tone separated because I got iron in this direction. It's pretty good size. I don't believe it's a side signal from the edge of the iron. It sounds like a quarter, real high pitch. About 3 inches at the most. We'll see what she is.
I love it when the plug comes out good and solid together. It's in my plug. Doesn't sound like a quarter anymore. Yeah, that's a penny. Just got the penny. Alright, moving on. This one is a real high pitch. There it is. Sounds like a quarter. Pretty much on top of the ground. I can get my detector to hold still and get her out. Did I miss it? Yeah, I missed it. Missed it by about an inch. What is one more clad quarter? Get a bunch more of those. Take them to the bank, get my cash, go buy silver. Alrighty, moving on. Alrighty, this sounds really high. Doesn't really have a whole lot of depth to it though. No, no. I can get that probe. So that tells me it's probably clad. Sounds like a quarter. Probably about an inch and a half down. Yeah, I think the plug. And it is, ta-da, another clad quarter. Moving on. Alright, this one's got some depth to it. Sounds like a penny. My guess is a nice deep wheat. It's showing that thing down around the 5-6 mark. Let me get set up on it and I'll get her out. Okay, here we go. Let's see what it is. I think it's a wheat. Could be an early wheat. It's got that low tone. It does have some goofy numbers, but they're a whole lot better than the goofy numbers I got out of that really green deep wheat. Silver on the edge, highly doubt it. Right there. Oh, there it is. See, it's green. Get that one cleaned up, get a date off when I get home. Alright, that's two really, really green deep wheats so far. Searching for the next hole. Okay, on this one here, I got about a 4-inch quarter tone. I'm getting close to the end of my hunt, and I'm starting to think this is what I call, it's going to be a reality day. You go out, you dig zero silver. It happens to me once in a while. Yep, and that's just a clad quarter, I can see it. Okay, yum. Really sounded good, too. Alrighty. Moving to the next hole. Alright, here we are with the digs of the day. Let's go through the scrap and garbage stuff first. A lot of low toners. There's a few things that were low tone. This little badge, I can't tell exactly what it says. It may be a tag from like maybe a rose plant. It could be the front of a bicycle tag thing. No idea. Don't think I'm gonna clean it up any more than that. Might straighten it a little bit. Some sort of a, I believe a door latch piece from like a deadbolt type setup. Probably earlier than the deadbolt. My wonderful fence post top thing rang up really good sound. Garden hose, call it, the part that crimps the end of it on there, part of the garden hose still in it. Let's see,
Not exactly sure what this badge is for. It says SF-4276 Vancouver, made in Korea, KSP. And on this site it says number one. No clue what it is. Some tag off of, who knows, maybe a fence. Not sure. The wooden nickel I spotted on top of the ground, nearly top ground, it's starting to dry out a little bit. It says Portland, Oregon. Oregon Brewers Festival, last weekend in July. The other side says one wooden nickel, Waterfront Park, Portland, Oregon, last weekend in July. Kind of a neat item to find. Got my penny pile. This dime here, as I got back in my truck, I happened to look down right by the driver's door and it was sitting on top of the ground. Another surface dime, the others are dug. Good day for quarters. This I didn't get on film. It's like a little locket, or at least half of it. Cleaned up pretty good. I don't believe it to be any quality metal. It looks gold, but it certainly doesn't seem like it is. I'll have it tested, but I'm sure it is not. Nearly a surface find. What this one says is Republic de Nicaragua, America Central. It's got kind of the pyramid symbol on the front of it. Different looking coin. The other side says, yeah, I'm not even going to try to read that. It's a 2000 coin, one Cordoba. So apparently a Nicaraguan one Cordoba, about size of a quarter. And then my wheats, the very first one I dug up, I don't think I took a scan of that hole and did it live, 1913. Nice early wheat. That one is really green, really deep. The other one I believe I got a live scan of, the 1920 D mint mark. Pretty good shape. It's about as good as I'll clean them. I might get them a little, I don't know if I'll clean them any more than that. So there we are in the day today. More of a reality day because there was not a single piece of silver to be dug by me today. Anyways, thanks for watching. If you're seeing this and you haven't subscribed, back up a video, maybe two videos. I'm doing a silver giveaway with some other special mint coins. So watch that video, follow the instructions, and hopefully you'll be a winner. Thanks for watching today. Subscribe, hit the like button, and we'll see you next time.